is the 2020 Range Rover HSE P525 Byron Blue. Comes with two keys. Does have the power adjuster tailgate. The rubber mats. You got the cargo carrier here. And your wheel lock key should be in there. Yep. It's a coat hanger here for the back of the headrests. And a hook there as well for purse or bags. And we got the cargo cover. Looks like there is some marking here. Here. Some marking here, maybe we can clean that up a little bit. You have the option to raise and lower the car and then drop the second row here with those buttons. So it does have a reduced spare. Back of the seats look good. Headliner looks good. It's a four-zone climate, so you get the additional air vents up top. You have the controls here as well. Two USB ports at the bottom with 12 volts. Seat looks good, armrests look good. Miles. This one has heads-up display, which is something you cannot get in brand new cars. It also has adaptive cruise control, which you cannot get in brand new cars. That's nice. So, gauge cluster fully customizable. You have auto wipers, auto headlights, auto taillights, so everything's gonna come on at night. Auto high beam assist as well for your high beams. CarPlay, Android Auto. So this one has Vision Assist, which gives you the heads-up display and also color-changing LED lights. So you can click here and you can change your colors. Seats, we have heated seats up front and heated seats in the rear. This one has cabin air ionization, so ionizes the particles in the air when it comes through the ventilation system. Here's your dynamic mode, eco, comfort, grass, gravel, snow, mud, ruts, sand, and a rock crawl. Car has a terrain response system that is very smart. It sends power to whatever wheel needs it, and traction and braking is maximized in nasty weather conditions. You can turn off auto start stop there. Auto airflow, you can change. If you hit auto here, you can change how aggressive you want the air conditioning to be. Air purity is for increased filtering, so the recirculation, you can just turn that off. Cup holders here with additional storage, USB down there, and you can raise and lower the car here. And then here is the two-speed transfer case, hill descent control, and this is just for your terrain response. You can turn these knobs here, or you can just use a screen, touch screen, up to you. Does have ample amount of storage here. Nice car, very clean. Seat controls here, memory seating for both passenger and driver. We have easy entry for access height, so if you're pulling up to pick someone up, you can hit this button and the car automatically drops for you. So it's a nice feature. It's got the Meridian sound system and sounds pretty good. So this is the Meridian surround sound, so it has an 825 watt system, it's 19 speakers, and sounds pretty good. Anyway, here it is. It seems pretty clean. The only thing I see right now is there's some scratching here on the screen, but there is a company I know that offers a way to kind of get rid of that, you know, with the protection, something over the screen. It's pretty nice. Anyway. If you have more questions for me, please let me know. And thanks for watching.